This is my big tree that is about to come down. Provides so much shade and it's so beautiful, but it's also all dead at the top. This is day two, and that was all that was left. And later on, you'll see the stump.
I'm coming home, I'm coming home. Tell the world I'm coming home. Let the rain wash away all the pain of yesterday. I know my kingdom awaits.
Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. It's a very warm day here. Maddie and I had a little pool time today and she's still napping. The boyfriend went to get us dinner, which was really nice of him. The dogs are, hold on. Shiva, come here. Come here. You can't wake her up, okay? Come here. Go lay down. The dogs are a little warm because it's, as I said, pretty hot. And my HVAC is not working. My unit outside is not working. My unit inside works. So for some reason, it doesn't get that cool. As much as I can tolerate it, the boyfriend hates it. The baby, you know, she's sleeping, so hopefully she doesn't wake up like a sweat mess. I mean, she'll take a bath later, but the dogs are a little hot. I just gave them some bones filled with peanut butter that were frozen to kind of cool them off a little. And Shiva, my big girl, is still not too happy with the heat, so hopefully she'll lay down on the towel floor and feel better. But, and some ice cubes in her water will probably be great. So, we've had a weekend because my birthday was this past weekend. So, my birthday was on Friday. So we did some outdoor stuff and then Maddie and I have been a little busy. So this video is a little collective of some cleaning and I'm still gonna come up with a menu for the week for the meal prep, which will be probably on Wednesday's video. But I did do some videos for the tree and I'm going to go outside and videotape the tree down. So when I was a kid, I remember when they said you can figure out how old a tree is by you count the rings. So I still have the stump in the yard, which I really do need grinded. Shiva, come back here, please. Don't go in there. Shiva, come on. Lay down in the hallway then. You cannot go in there and wake her up. Hold on. Okay, so I managed to block the bedroom so she could not wake the baby up, because if she woke her up, I'd be very upset because she hasn't been sleeping very well for her naps this week. So, as I was saying, you count the rings in the tree so you see how old the tree is. And the other day I counted and it's 50 years old. I was like, that tree, I thought it was older because my house is almost 90 years old, I think. It's like 88 years old, I believe. And I've lived here 11 years, so I don't know why there's such a glare over there. I thought it was really cool. So I'm gonna go videotape it and show you guys a little bit. You know, I had it when it was the tree, and then when they cut all the limbs down, they still had it up, and now it's all down. So it's my house looks different. It looks really different because when you drive up to your house and you have trees, and then all of a sudden you have this shade, and then it's not there. I only have sun. Lots of sun. So I still think I need to have it grinded to get it out of the yard, but they did put something in the tree to, I guess, like kill the stump or decay it maybe over time. I know you can do that. You can put stuff in it and it decays it over time. But let's go look at the tree. So this is the tree stump. Hopefully I can get it grinded soon, but it is 50 years old. I counted all the rings, so I thought that was pretty cool.
So here's
and it really needs to go, but hopefully it'll be gone soon. Okay, good morning everyone and welcome back to my channel. And I don't know why it seems dark in here when it's, I guess because it's a little overcast. So I woke up today to Shiva getting sick all over her bed, the floor, and the carpet. So we've been trying to clean that up and I still have to now reorganize underneath the sink because I made quite a mess out of it just trying to find the cleaner. So realize that's probably not a good idea. So She actually got sick on the couch too, so I have no idea what's wrong. Last week it was Phoenix, this week Shiva, and it's either they're eating something outside in the yard or it's their food. And last week when it was Phoenix, I took her off the food and I made her like brown rice and, or rice and beef, and gave her a little bit of that. And then I gave her some wet food that I had yesterday and she ate that and she was fine. And Phoenix stayed on the other, or Shiva stayed on the other food. And then now Shiva got sick. So I'm not really sure if it's the food or if it's the dirt that they're getting into in the garden. So we will be cleaning all that up right now. So let's clean up some, a big mess. So here goes. Damn, how do I respond? What if my son stares with a face like my own and says he wants to be like me when he's grown? Shit, but I ain't finished grown. Another night, the inevitable prolong. Let's go. Another day, another dawn. Come on. Just tell Keisha and Teresa I'll be better in the mold. Another lie that I carry on. I need to get back to the place I belong.
I'm coming
Come on.
Home. I'm coming home.
I'm coming
tell
home.
The world that I'm coming home.
Yeah.
Let the rain wash away all the pain of yesterday.
Ain't no
I know
pain.
My kingdom awaits, and they've forgiven my mistakes.
Thank
I'm
you.
Coming home.
I'm coming home.
Coming home.
I'm coming
tell
home.
The world that
yeah.
I'm coming.
Hey yo, check this
home.
Out. A house is not a home, I hate this song. Is a house really a home when your loved ones is gone? And niggas got the nerve to blame you for it. And you know you would've took the bullet if you saw
right.
it. But you felt it, and still feel it. And money can't make up for it, or conceal it. But you deal with it, and you keep ballin'. That's why I some liquor playboy, and we keep ballin'. Baby, we've been living in sin, cause we've been really in love, but we've been living as friends.
Yeah.
So you've been a guest in your own home. It's time to make your house your own. Pick up
I'm
the phone and come
home.
On.
Coming.
Well, to add to my day, Maddie had an accident on the couch, so I just cleaned that up. So it's a little wet, so now I cannot cover it with blankets or take care of it from earlier. So it has to sit and dry for a little while. So I have my Oxy. Why do I never want to remember the name of it? But my OxyClean bleach in my sink for the kitchen. I have both of the girls locked up right now. I tried giving Shiva some bread, and I tried giving her the rice and beef mixture that I made last week for Phoenix, and she doesn't seem to want to eat it all, so I really don't know if it's the food. I did change their food this time with Chewy, and I'm trying to think. I think last time they had an issue with Proplan, so I think I'm just gonna have to throw the rest of the food out, which really sucks because it's like half a 50-pound bag. So I know that they usually do really well with Rachel Ray, and I switch up their food all the time. Let me fix this camera. Hold on. I had a trainer years ago that used to tell me that. Get tired of listening to Bluey. that dogs get bored with food, so change it up. So with Chewy, I tend to try to change it up like every other time or every two times or something like that. So the past food that I had them on, I thought they were getting a little bored with it. So they are 9 and 6, so they tend to, they love their food, but they tend to get a little bit more finicky, I would say, sometimes. So I switched it up from like a grain-free food to the Proplan chicken and rice, I believe it is. And it was weird because last week Phoenix was sick and I thought she was eating the dirt in the garden from the raised flower bed. Yes, baby, go back to the potty, okay? You're almost done. So I thought that that's what was making Phoenix sick, and Shiva was still eating the food. So sometimes it's easier to see what it is depending on the dog. And then today, as I said, Shiva had a huge accident. You know, she threw up all her food. She pooped in her bed. And then when I went outside, I was looking in the backyard, and it almost looked like she had like diarrhea because where she goes to the bathroom, it almost looked like it had a little blood in her stool. So I'm really kind of concerned. Normally it's, I really want to like take her out on a leash and kind of see what she does to see what's wrong, because it's hard to tell when you're in the yard, because it could have been something that fell out of the tree. It could have been, you know, it's really hard to tell because I don't have anything like when it was with Monty. You know, Monty was getting sick. I think it's just her with the food. So I think she's just having a reaction to it maybe this week. So I'm going to keep an eye on both of them. And Phoenix seems fine. She was really lethargic last week. She seems good this week. Yes, baby? What are you going to tell me? Did you go on the potty? Go back to the potty then. I'll be right there. I'll be right there. Okay. What do you need to tell me? Successful potty. Very good. So as I was saying, I just like to keep an eye on them, and then instead of letting them have like free roam in the backyard, I'll put them on a leash and keep an eye on them for the rest of the day. And hopefully Shiva starts to eat something. It's not like her not to eat anything. I gave her a piece of bread and she wouldn't eat that either. So just might be something she ate in the yard. She eats a lot of sticks. So it really could be anything. Things that have never bothered them all of a sudden seem to be upsetting them a little. So I'll just really keep an eye the rest of the day. Finish cleaning the bed up, the couch up, so they can both like lay on the couch later. But surprisingly, Phoenix seems a lot better. So I don't really, I tend to think it might just be the food. I remember like a year ago I bought this food, and I think, neither one of them liked it. So I don't know why I'm thinking of it now, because neither one of them is reacting. And it's halfway through the bag. That's the funny thing. It's always halfway through the bag that something irritates them and they don't like it. So I gave Phoenix wet food yesterday. So I had some canned food and she ate that, and with her rice, and she seems fine. So I'm just going to really keep an eye on Shiva, because I worry when they don't feel well, and especially when I go back to work on Wednesday. So it's kind of like, I really got to figure out what's going on with the two of them, because it's not good when both of them don't feel well. And then it's hard, you know, with Maddie, because she doesn't understand that they don't feel well. And I think it's just something they really ate in the yard, because there are like wild strawberries. There's other things in the back of the yard that they tend to go to the back of the yard. So that's their little area where they do all their business, and tend to probably get into something that they probably shouldn't. So I'm just hoping that it's like a little bug and just goes away really quickly, and we don't have to go to the vet. But I will keep you guys updated. So we're just gonna finish cleaning up and take care of Miss Potty Dude. Potty. Yes. Why is your tush all red? Take care of her and finish some things up for today. Okay.
Living as friends, yeah. So you've been a guest in your own home. It's time to make your house your own. Pick up the phone, pick up
home. I'm coming home, tell the world that I'm coming home.
I'm coming home, I'm coming home. Tell the world I'm coming home. Let the rain wash away all the pain of yesterday. I know my kingdom away.
Okay, guys, so the couch is straightened up for now because the other blankets were in the wash because it was a mess. Most of the carpet's cleaned up. I'm probably gonna let it dry, and then maybe I'll rotate the carpet, because, or I'll just wait to make sure they're done being sick, because the part of the carpet that's on the other side of the couch is like brand new, so usually I'll rotate it if they get sick or something. So I'll probably just wait. Hopefully this just passes and she's okay and then by tomorrow, or I might have to take her to the vet. So we're just gonna keep an eye on her, and we're going to go to Produce Junction later today to get some veggies because I'm going to do a lot of vegetable and protein meals this week. I'm trying to cut back on the carbs a little bit and eat more of those. And I was going to make some tacos tonight. Well, taco meat today. But I'm going to try this girl's idea. And luckily, I really don't have a lot of shopping to do because I have a ton of food in my freezer. So I have a ton from ButcherBox. I have a lot of, I think I have 2 pounds of ground beef and I have burgers. So I'm probably gonna do burgers tonight for Steve. And then, because I do have the ButcherBox burgers and I do still have buns. So might as well do it before the buns go bad. So we're gonna do that today. And then we're probably, so we'll do a little grilling. And then I liked her idea, and I think it might be easier for meal prep for me because sometimes I tend to do too much and then the food tends to go to waste. So I have a HelloFresh and Every Plate meal left, which are both poblano beef tacos. So I'm probably going to prepare both of those today so Steve can have it for the week, and then I'm going to do like the poblano part, like relish for me for my ground turkey version. And then I also realized too that I just really do have a lot of food in the freezer and the fridge. So I don't need to go to the store, but I do need some veggies and some fruit. So that's the only reason why I'm going to Produce Junction, because around here that's like one of the best buys. They have, you can buy, almost like you can buy it in bulk. So if you go to, around here we have ShopRite's. Where my parents live, there's Stop and Shop. Here there's Giant, there's Whole Foods and stuff like that. But in the Northeast, there tends to be certain different types of grocery stores versus out West or in the Southwest or South. Like they're always different. Like in the South, where I grew up, they had Piggly Wiggly. So, and then when I lived in New Jersey, they had Food Town. And then in Connecticut, they have might still have ShopRite, but they have Stop and Shop. And in this area, there's Giant. There used to be, when I was a kid, Food Town, but there's not that anymore. So it just really depends on where you'd like to shop. A lot of people shop. I love to shop at Aldi, and Aldi is around the entire country. They usually have some great buys. But if you're trying to shop, and I do Trader Joe's a lot, as you guys know, I love Trader Joe's, but I drive to Princeton to do it. But what I was gonna say is, like, if you go and you buy like 2 red peppers at the grocery store, and you get like a nice sized red pepper, those 2 peppers might cost you $5. But if you go to this place, Produce Junction, you can buy a whole bag of them. And I'm talking a bag of red peppers for like $3 or $4. And they're huge. And I cut them up and I snack on them. I make them for my burrito bowls. So this week, that's what we're going to do. We're going to do a lot more veggies, brown rice and stuff. And I'm going to make a few different items. I'm going to do a chicken and a beef, or a chicken and ground turkey, I think. And then I'm just going to be able to make my bowls for work, because I do work 4 days this week because I had the extra day off last week. I'm back to my regular schedule. I had like an extra day for my birthday. But so I'm just going to do a lot of that. And then I'm probably going to do my overnight oats and protein shake. But I'm adding more protein to my meals. I want to try to get my protein up to like 150 grams of protein a day. So if I eat more protein, I'll stay fuller and I won't snack on stuff that I really shouldn't eat. So we are going to do that. And that will probably be Wednesday's video, because I'm going to finish this one up today and finish editing and get it up for you guys. So, then I have, like, hopefully Steve Mosel on tomorrow so I can put up a pool, or at least put it outside to get it ready. So it'll be nice. So Maddie will be happy. It's like a 10-foot wading pool. So it'll be great. She'll love it. She's excited about it. So, and then she can get her trampoline, hopefully, because the trees are all down now, so it looks nice. But we hope you guys have a great week, and we'll see you on Wednesday. Bye.